Hello and welcome to Photo 180 Digital Imaging. This is your instructor, Jay Reimer. For our very first demo, we're going to start at the very beginning. I'm going to show you how to create a catalog. This, of course, is assuming that you already have Lightroom installed on your computer and you're waiting to get ready and get going and start working on your images. Before we actually create a catalog, it's a really good idea to go through your pre-existing images and do some housekeeping. One of the common questions that I get when people are first learning Lightroom is, where are my images? And they have trouble connecting their older images with new ones that they make. And it's a good idea to start off by just going through your older images, come up with a system to organize them, and then as you add photos to it, it gets a lot easier to find things. If you've looked at your textbook at all, you'll see Scott Kelby has a section there on organizing your images. And I'll go ahead and do that right now just to kind of show how you might lay things out. So let's go into our Finder. And let's just make a new folder. Go make a new folder. We can call this Lightroom Images. And within this, depending on how you think and what makes sense to you in terms of organization, some of you may think of things in terms of dates. You might remember those very well. And that might make sense to you. For myself, as time goes by, the dates start to get fuzzier and fuzzier, but I will always remember the category. So I like to think of things in terms of, I might have events. These are usually things that I shoot for a client. I might also have a folder for my personal work. So I might call this art, or work in progress. And for me, when I see that, I'm always going to understand that that's not talking about work for clients or events or assignments, anything like that. This is my work. Another folder I might create could be commercial work. Within this, I might have further subdivide it by either the client name or the type of commercial work it could be. So for instance, I might have a folder that says beverage. I might have another one that says product. Might have another that says we could call this sports. And under that, I might have things like a current campaign I'm shooting for a chain of local athletic clubs that, so I have shots of their gyms and some of the spaces they have in there. That would also include some advertising shots for them where we're bringing in lights and treating it like a studio. But it also could include something like surfing shots for friends, something like that. So within the sports folder, I would add further folders just to specify what it is we're talking about. You can get as specific as you like or as general as you like, as long as years from now, when you try to figure out where you put something, it'll make sense to you. And it'll be clear and logical. Once you come up with a system, you just want to stay consistent with it. If you treat things differently over time and they're stashed in different folders, maybe once I shoot some beverage shots, which are a kind of product shot, maybe I put those in here, but I also have some in here, and it could get messy trying to find things. So you just want to remember to be clear and logical and consistent. Whatever you do. So after building some folders like this, I might go through old hard drives and just start dragging things in here. You may want to have the further step of within each of these categories, and maybe I have within product. Then maybe I break it down by year. Or if I have the same client, but I shoot for them over several years, I might have, the name of that client and which years I shot for them. But it's really up to you and what's going to make sense to you, so that you can retrieve things later. Now that you've gotten things organized, you're ready to start creating a catalog. As you can see here, I have images all ready. In Lightroom, I've got a catalog with a lot of folders. I've got things organized into several collections. So I've done this already. But let's go and start fresh and create a new catalog. It's pretty simple. First step, go to File, New Catalog, and we need to give this a name and tell it where we're going to save it. This catalog, just so that it's I don't confuse it with anything else, I'm going to call it Photo 180 Demo Catalog, and I'm going to save it in this folder that we just made. And within that, I'm going to create a folder that just says, oh, we can call it Lightroom Catalogs. I think it's a good idea to package your catalogs with your images. If you ever need to move things around, then if you have them together as one unit, it's a lot easier to Lightroom know where you've moved things. And as you notice, anytime you create a new catalog, once you're in Lightroom, or if you open a new one, it doesn't really move between them as seamlessly as we might like. Unfortunately, what it'll do is it closes down Lightroom and it restarts with the new catalog. So for some of you, that may be reason enough to keep everything in one catalog, and then within that catalog, organize it by collections. For others, if you don't mind it having to close down and restart every time you switch to a different catalog, then you're okay. But as you can see right now, we don't have anything here. My library contains nothing. On the left, you'll see this catalog right here. There's no photographs. We haven't imported anything yet, so there aren't any folders. This is really just a blank slate. Now that you've created a catalog, you're ready for the next video in our series, where we'll cover how to import images into your catalog, as well as how to organize and sort the images in your catalog.